All right, what's your name, by the way?
My name is Omar.
Omar who?
Omar Ilonye.
Okay, what do you do?
I'm a business lady. I'm a graduate.
A graduate of what? What did you study?
I studied health education from University of Middlesbrough.
Okay, good. You've been picking rubbish all the time today. Who asked you to do it?
Nobody. Not because we are fighting for our rights and we know what we want as a citizen of Nigeria to keep our country clean and to do the right thing. Since we are fighting for our rights, we also have to do the right thing. Whatever we need is our responsibility to keep this street clean so that the government will not have any way to accuse of anything. That's why you can see we are organized, there's hope, peace.
Okay, aside from the government holding you for perhaps littering the streets, what other implications are there in leaving the streets dirty, even as you protest?
Leaving the street dirty is not a right thing. Number one, it's not good for our health. And number two, when your place is clean, everybody will live right. And number three, the reason why we are doing this is because when we want to be a leader, you have to serve your people. That's the reason why they are growing big and there's no need for us to get angry. We never get tired of serving our country and also serving our people.
Okay, you have been working with her on this project. What motivates you? What's your motivation? What's your name, by the way?
I'm Jumoke.
Jumoke who?
Alright,
what do you do?
I'm a teacher.
Interesting. Okay, so what's your motivation in having to pick rubbish like at the venue or the protest ground?
First of all, I don't like it. I love to see the place clean. That's why I can't sit down where there is dirt. That's why I engage myself. Nobody has asked me to do this. It's a free will. I want to just keep the community clean, to keep the streets clean.
All right, so where was I? Okay, how long have you been doing this?
We've been doing it for a very long time.
Like?
Yes.
Okay, from the beginning of the protest. Alright, but what's it like? I mean, the future of this exercise, are you going to continue doing it? Okay, what exactly are we asking for? What do you want government to hear? Let's be so specific as to what...
EndSARS. And ending SARS is not about ending police brutality. Ending so many things like bad government. We want good government. As you can see, the poor are suffering in Nigeria. Those who are on top are not helping the matter at all. The poor are suffering. The education, they are children are schooling abroad, but we have good schools in Nigeria, but they have refused their children to school in Nigeria.
Okay, but this problem...
corruption is in Nigeria. So we want a stop. That's why this has never happened in the history of Nigeria. But we as youths, we said enough is enough. And we'll continue to do this until the government do something about it. If not, we will not leave the streets.
Okay, but the problems you have enumerated are somewhat systemic, and they've been with us for almost since the beginning of Nigeria. Why are we just taking it up now? And why starting with, why mentioning SARS while we talk about another thing?
Okay, sir. Something will linger about something. As you can see now, the economy of Nigeria is nothing to write home about. We cannot be buying rice, 1,000 naira per mudu. We cannot be buying maize, 300 naira per mudu. Enough is enough, sir. Enough is enough. That means the poor people will die of starvation. Enough is enough. We're not fighting for ourselves alone, for our unborn generation. We don't want our children to come and suffer what we are suffering. That's why we are doing this. And as long as we're on the streets, we'll continue to do this until the government hear us. We are not lazy Nigerians. Most of us here are graduates. We are not lazy Nigerians.
So
we want to prove to the government that yes.
I'm a master holder. Because a lot of people are saying they are jobless. They don't know what to do. But I'm a master holder and I'm proud to be here. I use my hand to do a lot of things. Like before I came out this morning, I made hair cream, I made shampoo. Which I can go around to say, but I say no, since we are fighting for our rights, everybody we are here for the same motive. I can't see everybody, but we the graduate, we know why we are here. We are fighting the stuff, we are fighting what our parents do not do. We are tired of don't go out. You heard what happened at terminals. There is a lot of rumor, don't go out, don't go out. But if you don't go out, who will go? Who are the leaders of tomorrow? We are the ones.
Okay, but people are saying that EndSARS protesters are the ones attacking people in terminals.
It's a big lie. You came here and you can see the leader, they have been talking.
Sir, people are not there.
You are sitting around, it is a lie.
Inside this protest, we've not gone to terminals. Where we've gone to is House of Assembly, Government House, and Secretariat. We've not gone to town at all. So those who are doing that, they are talks. We don't know them. We don't know them from anywhere. We are not talks. We are proud Nigerian youths.
And what happens to me in terminals? They are just out to stop us. Care, but we are not scared. Even today, we are as good Nigeria as our right. So we are not scared.
Well, thank you.